2 weeks. The car behind me here has absolutely broken the internet for a lot of reasons. People were calling the car ugly. People were trying to figure out, is it worth the money? Is all the aero that it's got actually functional? We're going to speak to Cobus from Franco Scrivanti Racing and chat about the Hill Climb GTR. So usually what I would have done is I would have had the phone up here and I would have been selfieing this whole thing, but the car's a little bit more special than that. And next to me is the legendary, what's it, the sheriff of Carltonville? What's it called?
It's actually just the sheriff.
Just the sheriff.
Yeah, it started okay. out with a wing in the front as the sheriff of okay. Carltonville, because I come from there.
Okay.
And we've decided, no, it's just going to be the sheriff.
Yeah. So, Cobus Jonker, chief mechanic for Scrivanti Racing. You guys would have seen him talking about the Porsche and the Chevron V19 and the V26. But today, we are talking about that Nissan GT-R. Cobus, why was this insane, Pavel? Because this car broke the internet.
Well, you know, everybody know that we went to the Hill Climb with a Porsche.
Yes.
And, you know, it wasn't like a failure, but we had to change the car up so much just to work on that mountain in terms of ride height. And when we started pushing the horsepower so hard on the Porsche, the internals of the gearbox didn't like that much.
Right.
So we said, let's focus on the Porsche, get the Porsche in front in circuit racing like we want to, mm-hmm. and then build something particular for the Hill Climb. And that's where this car came about.
Right.
So
apparently the car's, the base chassis, if you want to call it that, is from New Zealand.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, so the base starting point of the car was, we started in the beginning and say, what do we need? So we needed horsepower. We needed four-wheel drive. We need aero.
You need all the horsepower, all the all-wheel drive, and all the aero.
All the aero, and then we need a rigid chassis. So,
yeah.
So that's why we went for a space frame chassis. We went for the VR38 engine, which just, it gives you so much horsepower, it's, you know, you don't even ask nice.
Yeah.
And then, but
let's just touch it. So this particular VR38 engine, this one is not a stock. It's not a stock.
No, no.
It's got fully forged internals, all the bells and whistles.
Fully built engine. It's not a billet block though, but it's cams, valves, headwork, crank, sleeved, rods, pistons, everything you can think of that you can do in it, except it's not a billet engine, it's still the standard cost.
Well, while we're on the engine, let's just take you this way quickly.
Just admiring your car.
So, on the engine's not one particular manufacturer. I mean, you guys have got a lot of influence on this engine, and I see there's some alpha bits on there, there's some turbo smart bits over there. Tell me a little bit about the bolt-ons on this engine.
Well, we went for the alpha intake because we can do a double injector system per cylinder. So it's a primary and a secondary injector per cylinder. So just to give you an idea, it's 1700 IDXs, two on one cylinder. So on full bore, it's almost 3.2 liters of fuel that's been pushed through the engine.
Per minute?
Per minute, yeah, on 100% duty cycle. So
it's thirsty, dude.
It's thirsty, yes. And then we got Garrett GT35, a new generation turbos on it. And then from, like I said, anything inside that you can think of. It's got cams in, it's got a Winberg crank in, decent rods, decent pistons. It's running a dry sump system as well.
I know you actually got the oil pump on the inside.
Yeah, the main reason for, everybody asks why left-hand drive. We expected left-hand drive because most of the components, dry sump system, the prop shaft is off center on the car,
yep.
as well. So for weight distribution, it was advisable to go for left-hand
okay,
drive.
Okay, so we actually put some balance on.
Yeah, to have some balance to like counterbalance your drive.
So does this mean Franco's going to watch his diet? Boss, you can't go above 80 because the car's going to be unbalanced, so
well,
you've got to watch how you eat?
By the way that he's driving now, he doesn't have to watch anything. So.
Now he's pedaling this car.
Yes, yes.
So complete space frame chassis, completely work motor, as you said. What's happening with the suspension on this thing?
Well, Jason, firstly when the car came, nobody had in mind, you know, even the basic design of the car was never intended to do what we wanted to do with it, you know. So we had to redesign a lot of chassis components in terms of shocks, springs, bump rubbers, pump steer, casters, all of that to control the aero. Because in the beginning when the car came, it was so softly sprung that it would have just, all the aero would have just pushed the chassis into the ground.
Okay.
So we had to do a lot of suspension work to make all the aero work on the car, not force the car absolutely into the ground.
But that being said, and even with the stiffer springs, like at Knives in the Hill Climb, you've still got all the aero that you could possibly fit on this car, especially this thing here. This thing has been spoken about a lot, this front wing. From what I understand is, this was an afterthought. You had way too much downforce at the back and you needed to balance it out.
Yes.
So is that what happened here?
So yeah, so basically what happened here is we had an off-the-shelf splitter and wing that we bought from DAS. We also had DAS on board helping with all the aero. Mm-hmm. And because we had such short time, there was no time to do a proper aero package where we can ask our composite guys to make molds, cut stuff out of polystyrene and stuff like that. So we had to improvise. So what we did was is we 3D rendered our diffuser that we have on the back, which is actually our Porsche diffuser.
Yeah.
And we found out that we've got too much rear aero, rear downforce. And that's where the front wing came about. And it was actually the same wing that the Porsche had that big accident in PE.
Yeah.
And it's the same wing. So Sammy said, send me all the stuff through the profiles and all of that, and he came back and said, right guys, this is what we're gonna do. That's where this needs to be, that needs to be, that needs to be. And just to give you a quick idea, on 280 kilometers per hour, we've got 45 millimeters deflection. So in other words, the whole chassis pushes down 45 millimeters into the front. That's another reason why the car's stance is
so
actually
high,
a little bit higher for a race car. It's to compensate for the deflection that all the aero makes.
So yeah, so that's obviously what the aero basically does, is it puts weight on the car to keep it grounded. How much weight are we talking?
Well, we've worked it out. It was 650 kilograms per wheel on 240 kilometers. 1.2 ton in the front,
yes,
and 1.2
yes.
ton at the rear.
So this particular, let's go. So on the aero, right, this is not a permanent fixture. This front wing over there, although it's what this car has been spoken
exactly
about, it's not going to be around for much longer.
You know, I don't know. I can't tell you now. I think the wing made the car famous, although it was
it
against everybody's religion.
Nobody liked this fucking wing. Everybody hates it. I liked it.
But
I liked it because it was functional.
You know, I get stupid questions, like people still come in asking me, is this thing working?
Yeah. Why would it be here?
Exactly, you know, so it's here because it's working.
Yeah.
If it's going to stay, I can't tell you now.
Mm-hmm.
But for now, there's lots of other development to get done on the car.
Yeah.
For now, so we're going to focus on the important stuff. There's more suspension work, more aero work on subtle type of places where we can work on the car.
Horsepower.
Your horsepower is enough.
So look, when this car went out to Knives, I mean, we don't have a lot of time now, let's just go in the car, but this car gave a lot of ground before Knives and the Hill Climb. Knives and the Hill Climb, everything came together, the engine misfire was sorted out, it had a gearbox issue, the gearbox came in overnight, you guys installed it through the night and the car raced the next day. It was absolutely incredible what you guys went through to get this car together, sleepless nights, all those things, but when it finally got to Knives and the Hill Climb, this car is capable of 2,200 horsepower.
Well, there's a lot of figures. I'd say 2,000 wheel horsepower.
Okay.
2,200 is a little bit exaggerating,
okay,
but it's wheel horsepower.
Yeah.
With this current setup, it's 1,006.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
And just to give you an idea, we haven't even scratched the surface yet.
Yeah.
We were on medium boost at the yield line.
Which is about 1.2 bar?
Yeah, 1.3, 1.4,
okay,
and we made about 1,000, 1,002 on the roads.
Okay.
So there's no use in having all this horsepower if you can't use it.
Absolutely.
So definitely in the future we'll be able to use it, but the rest of the car is not there yet. So as soon as we figure out the rest of the car, then we'll start adding horsepower.
I think the final question is, what's next for the car? Where do you race the car next? Is it purely a hill climb car? I mean, we've got a couple of hill climbs coming up. Jaguar is exactly another year away. So what is the plan? Is it getting ready for the next hill climb?
Well, yeah, you got it. Our next event that we're targeting now is the Master of the Mile.
Yeah.
That is an event that's going to be held at Emerald Casino in
yes.
Vondervale Park.
That's it.
Which is not really a hill. It's just like an open circuit.
Yes.
So it's not a loop.
So it's more of a time attack.
More of a time attack, flat surface, lot of curves. So that would be our next run with it. And then we're hoping that Desi can finish his hill climb now so that we can go and do that. So it's mainly built for time attack and hill climbs. It won't be able to do a 15 lap race because of all the horsepower that you need to push, the fuel consumption, and you'll just overheat anything. So everything. So that's that's why mainly you'll climb in Diamond Duck.
Awesome. So the next time we see this car coming out, I mean, short of us doing some kind of a feature, is down at Emerald Casino at the, let's call it the Time Attack. And I can't wait to see what's different on the car, what you guys do differently from now until then. Corbis, thank you so much.
Pleasure, Jason.
I know we always appreciate it.
Yeah, it's a pleasure.
And guys, that is under the skirt of the... We need to figure out the name, bro. What is the name? There's been the Kraken, there's been
it's the Sheriff.
Is it the Sheriff?
No,
is that?
The Sheriff.
So I'm going to make a logo, everything
that's
the Sheriff.
The thing, it's the Sheriff, yes.
Boys and girls, the Franco Scrivanti, Sheriff, Hillclimb GTR. Catch you guys later.